In this video, we'll take a look at how to deal with reverse scored items on a Likert scale. And these are also known as negative items. For our example here, we're looking at an example where we're assessing perfectionism. And we're using the multidimensional perfectionism scale. And you can see the reference here for those of you who may be interested in looking this up and pulling the article. Now, what I did in this example was I just selected a few of the questions from the self-oriented perfectionism subscale of this scale here. So we've got four questions here, and these are also called items. So I'll be referring to these as items often as well. So we have question one or item one, question two or item two, and so on. And a person reads each question or item, such as the first one. One of my goals is to be perfect in everything I do. And if you think of someone here who is highly perfectionistic, or we think of them as a perfectionist, what is it that they would answer this question? Well, notice the scale ranges from strongly disagree to strongly agree, and we have numbers here to correspond to that continuum. And just as a quick side note, a 4 would be a neutral response, or it might read neither agree nor disagree. But the way the scale was constructed, we just have the anchors labeled, which you'll see for many scales. So if someone's highly perfectionistic and they read this question, one of my goals is to be perfect in everything I do, they should answer with either a 6 or a 7, right? Probably a 7, but a 6 is possible as well. But whatever their answer may be, it definitely should be on the high end of this continuum. They should indicate to some degree that they do strongly agree with this statement. Our next question, let's go ahead and read that. I strive to be as perfect as I can be. Once again, if we're thinking of a perfectionist, they should answer with a 6 or a 7 again. Now the next question is what I want to focus on here for a minute, really these last two questions. But question number 3, I never aim for perfection on my work. Now if we think about someone there who is a perfectionist, and they read this question, I never aim for perfection on my work, what should they do there, you want to ask yourself? Well, they most likely would strongly disagree, right? With a 1, answer with a 1, or maybe answer with a 2. And then as we read this last question, I seldom feel the need to be perfect. Well, a perfectionist definitely doesn't feel that way. They feel the need to be perfect, usually all of the time. So they're going to answer, again, on the strongly disagree end, so with a 1 or a 2. These last two questions are items where someone who is high on the trait, or we call it a construct being measured here, perfectionism, someone who is high on that variable, where they answer low on the scale, those are known as negative or reverse scored items. So these are special because we have to do something with these prior to creating a total score. And what we'll often do here is we'll add up the scores on these items here to create a total score. So for example, if someone answered all 4s, then they would get, if the scale consisted of just 4 questions, they would get a 16, 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4, and so on. Now in another video, I do go through how to add up items on a number of different questions, or put another way, how to add up a number of different variables. So you may want to take a look at that if you'd like more information on how to do that. But in this video, we're going to deal with just how do I handle these reverse coded items? How do I use SPSS to actually change the responses on a scale? So let's go ahead and look at that. So once again, a perfectionist answers with 7s on 1 and 2 and 1s on 3 and 4, or somewhere close to that. And the problem that happens here is that the instructions from the authors or the creators of the scale, as it's usually the case, is that high scores on the scale, since it's called perfectionism, high scores indicate someone who is highly perfectionistic. But if we look at this here, if we take the person's responses, let's say we have someone who responded in the most extreme way. So they got 7s on questions 1 and 2, and they got 1s on questions 3 and 4. Well, then their score would be, if we just literally added these up, it would be 7 plus 7 plus 1 plus 1, which would give us 16. Now, if you think about that, that is not a high score because the highest possible score, according to the scale, is 28, or 7 times 4 items. So something's wrong here. We need to work with this scale. We need to do something in order to get it so that someone who is high on perfectionism doesn't score a 16, but instead they score something like a 28. So what we need to do in SPSS is we need to do what's called reverse coding these items here.